Thank you. Thank you. That was a lot of energy. I like it. I like it this one.
You're guaranteed.
Well, first of all, hi everybody. Very happy to be here, and hopefully we have a great day. We got great coaching, and hopefully you learn a lot of great stuff. Can start with the Q&A. I don't know if you have the questions.
First thing in the morning, who got a question for Tony Parker? Let's say first. Usually we do this later today, so we can screen the questions a little bit.
Couple questions.
Come on, jump up there and go say hi to Tony. Aww. Get your question.
What's your question?
Wait a minute.
How do you feel? I'll repeat the question.
Keep it light.
How did you
feel
with Tim
Duncan?
It was a great experience. Obviously, I made my job easy. Tomorrow, from my opinion, he's the best power forward of all time. And so, for me, it was just all those 19 years winning those championships, obviously on the court, it was great. But what I remember the most is off the court. It was just a great friend. And I'll take all those memories and cherish them forever.
Coach, did Duncan like
it
when you drive it? Did he like the ball up in the air, up by the rim,
or
did he like the bounce picks to get together?
As long as
the pass is good. Who's got another question?
Come on
up here, hurry up. Hustle,
you gotta
hustle,
you
gotta play
the basketball.
How does Duncan feel if I'm with you?
Good question. I hope you like it. But what I can tell you is when I arrived in the NBA and I was 19 years old, coming from France, I don't think he was very confident that we were going to win with the French point guard. But we won 4 times, so thank you, guys. Watch NBA all the time and then go to school at the same time. Try to make my parents happy, so they both. So definitely enjoying it.
Coach, you go.
Hustle up, come on. Why is this really at the holiday company you have achieved?
It's year 16, so you've seen the whole because I'm passionate. Because I love playing basketball and love being with Coach Pop and my teammates. And I think I don't take it for granted. I feel like I'm very blessed and very lucky. And as long as I feel healthy, I want to keep going. Because you can only have one career. You can't play for forever, but I want to try to make it last. Every ex-player that I talk to, they always say you have to play as long as you can, but once it's over, it's over.
Good job, good job.
Let's say recently, a lot of the talk is about Trump, you know, and they're going to be like Trump, you know, so Coach Parkman is very funny about that. He's always playing overall. He's got a great outlook on life. He knows a lot to know about Europe and all the different places in the world that he travels. So he's definitely a great conversation.
Best commercial with the Cooking with Tony. So this year it will be Cooking with Tony part 2. So hopefully you'll like it. We've got a lot more guys coming in on commercials, and it's a lot of fun. It's a great experience to obviously playing basketball, you know, it's our job, but it's nice to do other stuff. So doing commercials, it's a great thing to do, and hopefully, you know, you'll keep liking it. Thanks, man.
Coach, we got one more question.
One more.
Then we'll play some ball.
How did it feel to play in the NBA? It was my dream, just like you. How old are you? You're 8 years old. So when I was 2 years old, I started playing basketball with my dad. My dad was a basketball player, and I used to play all the time. And since I was basically your age, my dream was to play in the NBA. So I worked hard at it. And lucky enough, you know, it happened. Thank you.
All right. Hey, let's give it up for Coach Parker. The Spurs.
Thank you guys. We're really honored to be with you guys. I always take those camps very seriously. I don't take it for granted. And one day I was your age. I was doing basketball camps, you know, everywhere in France, and a lot of different athletes always give me that good advice and giving me motivation to do something with my life. And so now I'm here today, and it always touched me a lot to see all those little kids that, you know, you can inspire. With my brother, we do a lot of things too in France, with like 1,000 kids, you know, every summer. And so I think it's always great to give back, and hopefully, you know, we give you motivation to do something with your life, because anything is possible. Born in Belgium, came from France, all the way to the NBA to San Antonio, Texas. So it's a good proof that anything can happen. So make sure you do something with your life. You only live once. Don't waste it. You know, work hard every day. Enjoy every day. Because you never know what can happen the next day. And hopefully I'll see you next year. Thank you.
My name is Duncan.
Duncan.
And what days do you practice on?
What days
do you practice on?
Oh, I practice every day. Every day we practice, you know, it never stops. You know, sometimes Coach Pop will give us days off. Like today was a day off, so I came here to play with you guys. But most of the time, you know, I always practice.
So keep practicing to perfect your game, right?
Exactly.
Right. Is that a question? Name and question.
My name's Lexi, and I'm wondering, how did you get this far in your life?
Meaning in basketball? Basically, yeah, starting in France and starting my professional career when I was 15 years old and played 4 years in France. And the Spurs, they had scouts, you know, everywhere in Europe. And so one day, one of the scouts, he came to watch me play. And so that's when they decided to draft me when I was 19. So then when I was 19, I decided to go straight to the NBA and skip college. And who I'm playing against. But if I have to choose, you know, a couple of guys who were really impressive physically, it was Shaq, Shaquille O'Neal, was really impressive. And Yao Ming, because he was 7'6", so I was a big guy.
All right, bud, name and question.
My name is Marcus, and what did it feel like to win the championship and lose it?
It's the best feeling in the world, you know, to win a championship. And losing a championship, obviously, is the worst feeling in the world. I was blessed enough to win 4 times, so... I realize, you know, a lot of guys, they go through their careers and they never win a championship. So it was nice to have that experience four times. So very lucky.